I gave this an awful lot of thought, and I'm afraid to say I just couldn't get past Donald Trump's penis. Now, I don't say that lightly, and I realize the consequences of uttering a statement like that. But when I was watching the debate, kind of the clips and the highlights the morning after,
it's huge.
You have a presidential nominee who basically comes on stage and says, I have a reasonable size cock, vote for me. And everybody cheers. You know, what has the world come to? I mean, Abraham Lincoln must have been thinking, you know, oh, I wish I'd have done that. I might have been, you know, around a little bit longer. But, you know, it was just an absolute sort of moment where you realize that the presidential election has become reality television. It's a celebrity contest now. And the idea that there is policy, particularly on the GOP side, and they're battling for an office that is the most powerful in the world, still, you could argue, you know, that's all out of the window now. It's just reality television.
It's gone from his hair to his cock.
Well,
yeah, basically, and you know, that
actually it actually went to hand size first.
Yeah, hand size first.
Yeah. Oh God! What'd you get, man?
My favorite story of the week. Get this right: this woman smuggled her child onto a plane between Istanbul and Paris, and she put the child, 4-year-old child, in a bag on the plane beneath her feet. And they only found out when this poor girl who was 4 had to go to the toilet. And so the passengers on the plane said, oh, there's a little girl there. And she got a ticket. I mean, this begs so many questions, doesn't it? I mean, how big was the bag? And wouldn't you be worried about suffocating the poor child?
How did it get through x-ray?
How did he get through x-ray? How did he get on the plane? Yeah. I mean, it's unbelievable, isn't it?
That's beyond unbelievable. That's frightening.
I've left you stranded for words.
Yeah. I mean, you know, in theory, you know, all carry-on baggage goes through an X-ray scanner. You would have thought that somebody would have said, "Well, yeah, that."
Yeah.
Unless maybe the child didn't get into the bag until after they'd been through security. There we go.
So
we're thinking like criminals now, Dario.
So it'd have to be in the departure lounge, wouldn't it? You know, she'd say, get in the bag.
Yeah, it just makes you worry about the mythology of safety, you know. Could you get on 10 pounds of cocaine or a bomb?
Exactly, yeah. Well, get a child on.
I mean, I've long, for many years, labelled it airport security theatre. So, I mean, you know, when you see what goes on, you realise there's really no way they could catch everything.
No, exactly.
I have two stories, but they're related.
Two,
yes. John Oliver, as we talked about before, had this wonderful takedown of Donald Trump in which he said, make Donald Drumpf again. Well, he made a series of hats, sold them out completely in a week. And the second story that's related to this is that Florida's Fort Lauderdale News Sun Sentinel, a pretty decent newspaper, one of my friends is one of the editors down there, they refused to endorse a Republican candidate. And they said, quote, the kind of person who should be running is not in the race.
Are they allowed? So they're allowed to do that, are they?
Why not?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not going to nominate anybody.
I'm not going to endorse anybody. I mean, you know, editorial endorsements are collected like chits anyways on the table by most of the candidates.
So should we be worried by the fact that Donald Trump is appearing in 2 of our stories of the week?
Well, Donald Trump is going to be appearing more when we get towards the end.
Sweet, in fact.
Yeah. So I guess we're guilty of perpetuating the Trump myth as well.